आई एम अ डर्मेटोलॉजिस्ट डॉक्टर इरफाना पाटिल फ्रॉम फॉरएवर यंग स्किन क्लिनिक कोल्हापुर. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट पेरी ऑर्बिटल हाइपरपिगमेंटेशन और डार्क सर्कल्स और पेरी ऑर्बिटल मेलानोसिस. पेरी ऑर्बिटल मेलानोसिस और अंडर आई डार्क सर्कल्स कैन बी अ नाइटमेयर फॉर मेनी ऑफ अस. इट इज कॉमन इन द फीमेल्स स्पेशली इन द एज ग्रुप ऑफ 16 टू 25 ईयर्स. Under eye dark circles can be multifactorial. They can be endogenous and exogenous causes as well. It is very important to find out the cause of under eye dark circles so that the treatment can be planned accordingly. If it is multifactorial, no single treatment is going to give you that good result. You have to combine the treatments to get a good outcome. It is important to rule out endogenous causes like genetic or hereditary predispositions for the under-eye dark circles. Now, it is very common if one of the parent or both have under-eye dark circles, then the child is also prone to get those. Under-eye dark circles can also be seen in various deficiencies, nutritional deficiencies like anemia or B12 deficiency as well. Stress, lack of sleep, various sleep disturbances, longer screen time, especially with this pandemic where we end up spending a lot of time with our mobiles and with the laptop and the television. It can cause tiring and exhaustion, and the skin around the eyes can look tired and increase the periorbital melanosis. This kind of allergies, allergic contact dermatitis to certain allergens, can also cause eczemas around the eyes, and contact dermatitis and cause a lot of itching and rubbing can increase the pigmentation around the eyes. Acanthosis nigricans, which can be commonly seen in insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus, can also cause thickening and darkening of the skin around the eyes, around the mouth, and also the forehead. So it is important to rule out underlying systemic causes also when you are looking at periorbital melanosis. Under eye dark circles can also be an extension of the pigmentary demarcation lines, which are already present and commonly found in the Asian population, especially in the females. So it is important for you to examine or to have a complete look if whether it's an extension of the PDL itself. Excessive alcohol consumption and smoking can also lead to periorbital melanosis. And last but not the least, anatomical variations in the bony socket. Hollowness under the eye can cause deep-seated eyeballs and a shadowing effect and periorbital melanosis. And this seems to be very common, especially in our Indian females in the middle age group. So it is important to correct that cause to get a complete good outcome for the treatment. Stay tuned to my channel to follow my subsequent videos where I will be discussing the treatment options for under eye dark circles. Thank you.